the whole world gonna owe me an apology because I went through this and I ain't blow my brains out like Kurt Cobain. And I should, because this is the crazy mess.
And the shuffling madness of the locomotive breath runs the all-time loser headlong to his death. Oh, it feels the piston scraping, steam breaking on his brow. Old Charlie stole the handle and the train in watchtop, going nowhere to slow down. Oh, he sees his children jumping off stations one by one. His woman and his best friend in bed and having fun. Oh, it's crawling down the corridor on his hands and knees. Oh, Charlie stole the handle and the train in one stop, going nowhere to slow down.
Drop it now!
The silence
drop
howling
the gun. Drop the gun.
As they fall.
All-time winner. Hey, just fire, taser boy.
Has got him by the balls. Oh, it picks up Gideon's Bible. Oh, that page one. I thank God he stole the handle. And the train in watchtop, going away to slow down.
Took me a long time to do this. I ain't really want to do it, but I had no choice, man. My story has to be heard like the rest of us.
For me, my targeting started almost exactly 3 years ago. In that 3 years, I've experienced absolute hell. Unspeakable things I can't even hardly describe, but
I'm a targeted individual. I'm being involuntarily experimented on without my permission. With directed energy weapons, voice to skull, synthetic telepathy. I'm being tortured every day with electromagnetic frequencies.
But you see, the artificial intelligence, it works on everybody. It's everywhere. And no human runs it. No human being runs the system. It runs itself.
I've attempted suicide 3 times. I've been hospitalized several times. I lost custody of my son, which I've now regained.
I have been thrown in a mental institution. I have been poisoned. My food has been poisoned. I have been mentally and psychologically tricked.
It's self-run. Computer. Master hive mind computer. What it does kind of like the NSA, collect data on you, and this could sound crazy, but somehow it participates with this gang stalking program.
First, let me say that I still am a target. I am still being targeted. However, it is much more manageable than it was.
You know, it's just way far out, man. They use holographic images. They can put you in a situation where you visualize a situation that never really happened, and then broadcast it on the television and make it seem like it happened. And then once you, you know, actually check your body, and you know, you really like put use logic, you be like, hey, that didn't never really happen. So, you know, this technology that they're using is so far advanced, man, and it's designed to torture and destroy your, you know, what you stand for. And you know,
it could send people to come around you and harass you in a way, indirectly. You know what I'm talking about if you're being gang stalked. It's like warfare.
Today, you know, so when this first started, and for the first 2 years, I had these non-stop voices, these people, seemingly people, constantly in my ear, in my head, talking, you know, berating me, very critical of everything, you know, that makes me who I was.
On a spiritual level, it can destroy, you can be praying and they can put, you know, perverted, you know, evil thoughts into your head. They can pretty much, whatever it is that they want to do to you, you know, as far as like psychologically.
They can cause these people to go and find you and go wherever you are without them even knowing about it and participate in this harassment program.
You know, they'll have people break into your house, they'll have people follow you, they'll have people gang stalk you, they'll take family members and use certain applications on their phone to try to put certain things in your head, and everybody's walking around crazy like demonic robots talking about, let's control them. You know, it's the sickest thing that I've ever seen before in my life, and I never would imagine in a million years, my 36 years of living in the United States, that I would be going through this.
Now, there's also satanic cults who knowingly participate in the gang stalking, which is what I've been a victim of, is knowingly being gang stalked.
You know, today I hear a one or two word comment a few times a day. Not very distracting. Very manageable. I still get, you know, ringing in my ears.
Honestly, I never knew anything about this until I became a targeted individual. I didn't realize I was a target until I started hearing, you know, people around me say that I was on television, and I checked every television channel and I could not find not one, you know, broadcasting me personally. So
and that's a big deal. That's a big part of this, is not letting it consume your life. You know, the first thing I did, I think that really made a change, was you know, they made these voices, they made me super conscious of who I was. I mean, they really broke me down. They broke me down to, you know, the fabrics of my being.
But there's also the AI system that collects data on you, the master computer. You know, YouTube, anything you do on the internet is recorded by this AI system. And somehow they intervene with your life with this kind of stuff.
You know, I just started hearing the neighbors' TV. I started hearing people around me talk about me, like everywhere I went, like everybody knew who I was. And a lot of funny stuff started happening in my life the way it's just unexplainable. And I realized that, you know, something is going on that is far out, that I never would have known that even was capable of happening.
When you're letting this be all consuming, and you're spending all this time and effort trying to like explain to everybody this is happening to you, and trying to do everything you can to fight it, and you know, you're talking to, you're interacting with these voices, well, it just gets worse. It just gets worse and worse and worse. Like, I know that when I used to have suicidal thoughts, the worse my thinking got, the further they took me down that road, further than I was willing to go and wanting to go.
It's beginning to look more and more like the grand scheme of this gang stalking thing is an AI system. It's a computer. And think about it. It's artificial life. It's not organic. Who do you think creates artificial life to combat organic life?
So here's, you know, here's some things that I think are important. Okay. Stop interacting with the voices. If you have these voices, stop interacting with them. Chances are they're not really people. It's more than likely a sophisticated computer program that's designed to interact with your mind. Because I know for me personally, I had the same voices in my head every day, 24 hours, you know, 16 hours a day. And so that meant that these people, if they were real people, they have no other life other than fucking with mine. And that just doesn't make any sense. There's just no way.
I don't know exactly how I became targeted, who I pissed off, or why they chose me. All I know is it's been 5 years now, and the most unexplainable things has been happening. But I've been doing my research, and I've reaching out to other targets throughout the United States, and it's clear as day that they're experimenting on, you know, several thousands of people.
So we are at a war with synthetic artificial intelligence programs and maybe even beings.
Fuck them. I'm gonna take my life back, and I'm gonna try to take it, you know, to a whole new level.
It's unethical, it's against our will, and it's very deceiving, man. They deceive the public into thinking that it's gonna be okay and that it's harmless, but it's really based on a lot of lies, backstabbing. People lie in your face on a daily basis. You know, people try to kill you on a regular. You know, you try to get a job, they stalk you on your job.
What I thought was, no, there's no way. There's no way this could be real. But the more I get to think about it, and the more I experience this thing, the more it seems like a AI system.
Well, now they're making my whole brain complicated, where I have to constantly keep blocking out these thoughts that they're putting in my head, and it's very sick, it's very perverted, it's very disgusting, it's vile, it has no meaning, no end, it's 24 hours in a day, 7 days a week.
There's no way that's possible. There's no way possible that people 16 hours a day, 7 days a week, without ever taking a vacation, are fucking with your life. Stop interacting with them. As soon as you stop interacting with them, they're going to start quieting down a little bit.
And yeah, there are some of us that are targeted by satanic cults for gang stalking because they want us in their system.
You know, every 24 hours a day, you feel like you're being, you know, psychologically monitored and spied on by people that you can't even see, that you don't even know.
But, you know, you got to stop feeling sorry for yourself. You have every reason to. What you're experiencing is just terrible. It's inhumane. Nobody should ever have to experience this.
But we will have a war with this AI system, and it has to end. We have to destroy it, or it's going to destroy us.
And from what I see, it affects the people around you. I don't know if they hire or if they give incentives to people around you, but it affects the people around you because now they start acting crazy and funny too, and they don't want to admit it. But you can clearly see it, because if you know these people for more than 10, 15 years, you know how they act normal.
I've experienced shit that is indescribable. It's unthinkable. And I made it out okay. And that was the thing you got to think about, is you are a resilient person. You're a human being. Human beings are pretty resilient.
It is meant to fuck your mind up. And it did. It fucked my mind up big time.
It could be numerous things from what I researched. It could start from some organizations in the streets who got their hands on this technology and just wanted to try to get you out of there. Or it could have been the medical field. You know, a lot of people are in on this, so it's hard to really say who and how and why and where But just know that it is. And it's horrible, man. It's torture, man. 24/7, man. And each year goes past, it gets worse, you know.
You know, so all this energy you're spending thinking like, okay, I'm going to detect this, I'm going to prove it to people, I'm going to explain this to people. Look, this is designed to look like mental illness. This program is designed to make us look crazy. So you have just such an uphill battle, and the more energy you put on trying to fight this and trying to expose it, the harder they're going to make it on you.
Oh. It literally drove me crazy. The AI system. Not just the gang stalking. I mean, the gang stalking is just, it's right out in your face most of the time. Right in front of you. But the AI can fuck with you.
It's just so much, man, that all of us have, you know, said, but, you know, it's they have programmers sitting in behind the scenes somewhere where they're trying to program your brain to do this, do that, or whatever it is, like a video game, and they sit back and they laugh all day long like demons and just laugh and laugh and laugh.
I can fucking handle anything that the natural world will throw at me. I mean, I've been through fucking hell. So anything the natural world's gonna throw at me, well, fucking bring that on. That's nothing compared to the fucking unnatural hell that I've experienced. And, you know, and so I think that's kind of an attitude that every target should have. It's like, look.
But this system will destroy your brain if you don't understand what's going on. And it did that for about 2 years of my life. And then I started waking up, found God, and here I am today.
You know, I'm not, none of the things that they try to put in my head. I believe in God. I haven't done anything, you know, over the edge to where I have a bad reputation for myself. You know, I have 2 kids. I have to pick my kids up from the daycare sometimes, and they don't care. They'll try to attack me and get me to not be able to pick my kids up from school. And
my world came apart. I was in a day-to-day hell, an unrelenting hell, with no hope, you know.
So AI systems, one of the greatest dangers to organic life forms has ever existed.
Sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.